What are some of your best FD moments with us?
My first time whooping your ass, dude. I know, I was like, if I finish the championship second, I might have to come back at some point. My next plan is 3 years. Like, I got to put 3 years to that.
But you know what?
Take the
risk. Do whatever it is you want to do in any moment.
Yep.
So we're doing, is this where we tell everybody that I fired you?
Yep, Vaughn fired me.
You're out, dude.
Yep, I talked too much shit and that was it.
That was it, dude. Pack one dude on the trailer too loud and, you know, fickle times over
here. I even went through so many less bumpers this year just to appease you.
I know, you did a really good job on that.
I think like only 5 or 6 all year.
I mean, we should admire your car after Irwindale. Well, I mean, you didn't drive too much, but.
Well, you only did one more lap than I did.
One more time. Sorry, yeah. One more time.
Okay.
Yeah, 4 more laps.
James didn't even have to get into competition before his car was
gosh,
totaled out.
Dude.
I just laughed because my car was just sitting in the corner like almost perfect. There's a scuff on the bumper and I see your two cars yard sale to pieces.
I feel like Matt Field might have cost us more than you won for the championships this year.
Might have? For sure has cost us. I was like, I seriously can't believe. I told Matt when that whole thing went down, I'm like, I don't think anybody's really at fault here, but dude, like aim for a different kind of car here. Like, right. Let's just switch it up a little bit because you just keep taking us out. He's like, bro, I know. He's like, I don't even know what happened. I'm like, yeah, that's the problem.
Right.
None of us do.
Start there, yeah. Anyway, that's drifting.
That's drifting.
So yes, yeah, man, we're evolving.
We're evolving. It's crazy. I'm out.
Later, nerds.
You are.
Sorry.
Out of form of drift.
Yeah.
Don't be sorry. I'm stoked for you.
Yeah, it's been a wild last few years. I've been, like, fighting, trying to find that balance of everything. And, like, I think I found it, actually, like, this year. And I found that I don't really enjoy the balance that way. And I think there's just a lot more for me out there and drifting to be extreme and to do what I want to do and build that and, like, kind of take that next step of, like, expressing myself a little bit more with driving.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, we've been talking about it for years.
Yeah.
And I think helped you maintain for a couple of years to try to, like, find those other challenges. But,
yeah.
Like, when I'm explaining to people, you know, because obviously we have the conversations with the partners and, you know, everybody loves you and including me.
Thanks,
but,
bro.
You know, I think the way I explain it is, like, yo, Chelsea wants to be a street skater versus a comp skater.
Yeah.
You know, or BMX or like whatever, freestyle versus racing. And you know, for me, like, I totally get it and respect it. I mean, you know what I did a couple years ago? I took a break from FD.
Yeah.
and I my passion got relit and I wanted to go compete some more, and I came back this year and did that. And you know, I think one comparison for you to take is like that of Travis Pastrana.
Yeah.
Right? Where Travis was
this hits pretty hard for sure.
Yeah, because like, yo, you like right now from the outside, you have the dream.
Yep.
Right. You're with the, you know, I'll be cocky. We're the best team in Formula D. And we've got the.
It's kind of not arguable at this current moment.
Yeah.
So
you know,
we'll go with that.
And, you know, but, you know, you've been taken care of well, right?
Yeah,
I mean,
for sure.
You know, it's not like you're, you know, not making any money. It's not that you don't show up with a car that's ready to kill. It's not like, you know, your travel's not booked and your partners are sorted. You know what I mean? Like,
no, it's great.
It's the dream. But one of the things I love about you is, like, you have a thing inside of you that drives you is very different than what drives a lot of other people. You know, for me, like, it's smiles on faces and, you know, and having fun with my team and doing this. I know you enjoy those things, but that's not like your pulse. Your pulse is you being better, you showing your creativity and challenging yourself every lap. And like, you just have a very different approach to it that I've grown to respect.
Yeah, I think it too. Like, it took me a while to figure that out because, like, I was always like, man, like, I gotta just drive harder and better. And my spotter,
Clay, and I'm like, no, chill
Clay
out.
Clay would be
dude.
Like, bro, like, you need to stop. Like, you've already surpassed. Like, this is it. Anything you do past this now is just going into a territory where it's just not replicatable every single time. Like, and I'm
and
like,
you're like, yeah, it is.
I'm like, it is though. Like, what do you mean? Like, but I grew up doing the same thing, like riding BMX. You know, like, as a 10-year-old kid, it was like, oh, you just keep moving the landing back farther and farther and farther. You crash, but you don't move it back. You go back and you do it again.
You go bigger.
And you go again. And when you get pissed off and you can't land it, and it's already surpassed what you do, you move it back another foot because you know you'll achieve it then because you're going for it. And like, that's kind of been my mentality forever. And I think drifting was always like that for the longest time. because I was always fighting so many battles, like my own program, my own team, and like all, even though it's not on track, there's battles all the time that you got to win. Like, you know, when you're, especially when you're doing most of it yourself and having some help from some people, like, but this was like cool because it's like, man, I show up, great car, like you were saying, all that stuff, it's amazing. But also, like, now the challenge is the track. It's on the track. Like, how do I find this fulfillment where I reach my goals, everything? And, like, we've talked about in the past, you're like, little goals, little goals, little goals. And, like, that helps. And that sustained me for probably another year. And then it was, like, a year of, man, I never will get to drive with these guys again. You know, like, where else do I go that I get to drive with 40 of the best drivers that are doing the best they can do? Like, we can go get everybody together for a jam sesh. It's going to be great. It's going to be a ton of fun. But they're also not trying to win and beat everybody, right?
Right.
So there's like, this is the only place to do it. So that was another year of like hanging on with that. And then this year I was kind of like, okay, I got halfway through. We had some things and I'm like, I'm just going to win the rest of the season because I'm out. And like, it wasn't about like overdriving. It was just don't take any risk. Let everybody else make the mistake. Like, and that's it. Like, I played tennis in a previous life, basically. And, like, that you don't ever win off of, like, the winner shot. You get two of three of those. You win off of just being there and letting the other dude make mistakes. Yep. So I, like, kind of took that philosophy. And it was helpful for me to get through it again. I found something new, you know, to enjoy.
Basically the thing I've been telling him for 7 years.
Yeah, it's just how you worded it, I guess.
Yeah, it's a bad word. Bad word.
Bro, you got to turn it down. Like, nobody's turning me down.
Well, I mean, look, in Formula D, the way to win championships is be consistent. And it's easier said than done,
yep.
But it's a game. You know,
no,
we've talked about this. It's a game, and this is the box you play. And at driving 90%, that's how you win championships,
yep.
Right? Like, look at Osmo,
yep.
Right? Not the most exciting driver to watch.
Yeah.
Dude kills
wins
it.
A ton of things. Yeah.
When he's at Gapville, one of the most exciting drivers to watch.
Yeah, for sure.
Right? Look at me in my championship years.
Yep.
Right? I tone down my aggressiveness. I'm not having as much fun behind the wheel, but I'm there to do a job.
Yeah.
You know, I go to grid life. We're throwing it backwards, weaving in and out of traffic, having, doing what drifting is. And I started to say about Travis, right? So just to step back for that.
You.
No, I kind of.
Because this is like a big thing.
I kind of took us.
This is big.
Yeah, and I sent this to Chelsea when we were having these discussions, considering things. And, you know, Pastrana had the full deal, right? Young kid, 16, 17 years old, full factory ride with Suzuki, the dream, right? Of the motocross guy.
Yep.
And he left all of that to go do freestyle.
Yeah.
And, like, look what he's gone on to do in freestyle and curating a whole new culture around that thing, right? Around racing dirt bikes. Now there's this offshoot for the drifters of motocross,
right.
Which is freestyle moto. So, you know, and so, like, again, people have been asking me, well, what's going on? Because it came out of the blue for a lot of people. And I'm like, this is not a surprise. To me.
Like, we have been talking about it for so long that I'm like, people aren't even going to be, like, surprised. And you're like, yeah, you're out of your mind.
Yeah.
But it's just because, like, between my very tight core group of people, it's been a discussion because I'm bouncing ideas off of people, getting people's perspectives and all this stuff. And it's like, I feel like people aren't going to be that surprised. But people were very surprised.
Super surprised. Like I said, like, man, from the outside.
Man, it's crazy.
Like, dude, you're at the top of your peak. You're about to win a championship.
Yeah.
You know, and so... But anyway, like I've told you, I'm super proud that not many people step out of the comfort zone.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you got a cushy thing right now, right?
For sure.
And so to step out and be like, you know what, there's something more for me, and I don't know exactly what that is in this moment, but I know it is, and I'm going to figure it out. And I also have zero doubt that you're going to figure it out.
Yeah, it's tough. I have a little bit, but like I know I'm going to figure it out. No, it's just like a... Like, I have plans, I have ideas and things, but, like, the reality of it is, and, like, why we've had this conversation a bunch of times is, like, I don't even know that because I only know this. And, like, that's the thing is, like, I only know competing in drifting. I've been competing in drifting, whether it was FD or earlier series or whatever, for, like, 18 years now. Like, it's, like, that's all I know. And, like, all I've known is improving and building and building and building. And I'm, like... Like, I don't mean to talk smack about FD at all, but it's like, there is a box, like you were saying, like, there's a box for driving, there's a box for the entire championship, there's a box for every little thing you've got going on, and I'm like, I'm always, like, on the very corners of every box, maybe out of the box a little bit here and there, and, like, finding where that is, and, like, I'm like, ah, I wish I just had didn't have any limitations. Like, how do I not have any limitations? Well, it's almost impossible to not have any. There's always going to be something. And that's kind of probably a good thing, or I would get myself hurt all the time. But, like, I'm like, I don't know that next step until I go and do it. I have an idea of what it's like, but, like, I just know that, like, whatever I do, like, I just need to be the best I can at it, and it's going to be successful, I feel like, you know, no matter what.
There's no doubt. I mean, you got, you're a great dude. You're a fun-ass driver to watch. You're creative. People love you. Like, it's going to be awesome, and we're going to continue to have a damn good time. And yeah. I also think it's worth mentioning this about FD, because you talked about the box.
Yeah.
I think it's worth kind of offering some perspective of FD, because, you know, there's a lot of people that go to the judges and do that.
This is a point I wanted to talk about,
I think
too.
It's worth mentioning that, like, FD is the most successful drifting series in the world.
Oh, yeah.
And when I say that, not only, like, are they selling out and they have great viewership and great partners, but they've created a platform, the greatest platform in the world for people to drift and make a living.
Yeah, that's the only, I wouldn't even be doing any of this if had I not do this.
Right.
Like, they've, like, literally, like, between you and FD and everything, have paved the way so that I can do this. Like,
right.
Otherwise, if I just tried to do this, if I could be the best drifter in the world, it wouldn't matter. If I didn't do something that I was able to build something off of and build credibility and build a way to be able to compare myself to other drivers and build out a style.
Yeah.
It's the same thing, yeah.
But that box is based on 20 years of trial and error and evolving with the market and evolving with the sport. And so I feel like they get a bad rap, but it's like when you break it down as to like what is required to support that. I mean, there's thousands of people employed because of Formula D.
Thousands.
And so
there's businesses. There's everything. There's cities and
parts,
wanting to give budget.
I mean, you know, companies like WiseFab look how massive BC is because of the drifting movement. And you can say it or not, but like it started. FD has been a huge proponent of it. That's created the culture that we all love around it. And so it gets a bad rap, I think, because it is the big, you know, 2,000-pound gorilla in it. But it's like, I've watched the evolution from 04 till now, and I feel like they're doing a great job. Like, I think there's things that they can improve on, but overall, it's like, hey, I'm like, let's just give them a little break. you know, everyone's rough on them and, you know, think that they can do it way better, but... You know,
there really is, because the thing is like, sure, okay, let's take one thing to focus on with FD. Sure, there's improvements that can be made. But like, also, you don't think about the 500 other things involved in that one thing.
Yeah.
You're like, oh, they should do this. Why do they go to this track? It's like, well, they go to this track so that they can have this track.
Right.
Now do we want to argue still?
Right.
Like, oh, they do this so they can do this. There's always like a very easy argument.
Yeah.
But from a viewer's standpoint, I think it's like, okay, the judges decide everything, right? So no matter what, they're 50% wrong all the time. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it doesn't even matter if it's like somebody obliterates somebody. Someone's always got something to say, because that's the pivoting moment that they're all standing there watching TV waiting for an answer.
Yeah.
You know? And then, oh, there's this, that. And like, it's like...
The judges are working in a box, too.
They are, too. Right. And they...
You know what I mean?
The other thing, too, is like, I wish I could, like, post the driver's meetings and like explain to people all the time, because it's like they literally told us not to do that. I did that. I lost. That's how it works. Sure, my run might have been way better than the other dudes, but I did something
that
they said we don't want to see.
Yeah.
You know, now that I explain that to you, everyone's like, oh, okay. Well, then that makes sense why you lost.
Yeah.
You know, like whatever the case is, it's always like something. But yeah.
So it's interesting to think about, you know, and I think, you know, I believe that some people have the perspective that you're just like fed up with FD, and I think it's probably good to clear that you're more, that it's more, in my belief is that it's a bit constraining to like your goal and your vibe. Like, you're a peacock, do you gotta spread your wings? And like,
I think it's just a championship thing, honestly. That's what like I've narrowed it down to, is like, you like, from what I want and what I want to build and what I feel and what I need out of drifting, a championship makes that really hard, because it's like a lot of different things. It's like you said, there's a box. You drive a certain way, you do a certain thing, you let people make mistakes, you do all that. And like, if you're good at driving and you have reliable equipment, like, if you do that, you're going to be top five every year.
Mm.
If you just don't overdrive it, let them make mistakes, whatever, right? And then every time you win or lose, it's a huge detriment to the whole championship, right? So obviously we try to go run by run and all that stuff, but when you get knocked out or you lose or something, you're thinking like immediately you go from not run by run to, damn it, this is gonna hurt my eighth round. Like, this is where this goes. And like, that's my one chance where I made a mistake in 32, like I can't do that again. And then maybe the call you don't agree with or whatever, it turns into this whole thing. Like, it's like when there's not a championship involved, it's like, oh, I could just go out and drive however I want. Like when I watched you drive in Atlanta, it was the most calculated chaos I've ever seen you do in your life. It was like every chance you could take a risk, you took it. But at the same time, it was planned. It's like, that's where I know I can attack. That's where I know I can do this. And normal driving, when I've seen you in the past fighting a championship, you do that two or three times in an event. But yeah. It was like in Atlanta, it was like every run he took the chance. Because it was like you were just there. Not a championship. I'm winning this thing. Like I'm putting it out there.
Yeah.
And I can take a little bit more risk than what I want to, than I used to, because there's not an end goal.
I'm not
right?
worried about what happens when I get to Irwindale.
Right. Yeah. And I think that's like something that's worth it for me is like FD. It wouldn't, if it was FD or if it was DMAC or if it was whatever, any of these series, like the championship thing, I would end up being back to the same thing where I'm like, damn it, I'm in this box again. Like, I want to just go drive. Like, how do I do this, you know?
No, I think it's awesome that you're, you know, you're stepping back and going to do what you want. And, you know, I think I know where it ends up in the future. But I'm excited for you to, I'm excited to be along and see what you're doing. And, you know, a lot of great memories we've had over the last 7 years that started with you walking in my trailer as I was packing my shit.
At Irwindale.
As I was packing my shit on the trailer at Irwindale. I forget what happened. I think I knocked out in top 32 something.
I think I was like, hey, man, I know you're probably having a bad day with the scenario that just happened, but like, maybe I can brighten it up because I'm driving for you next year.
Yeah, that's exactly how it went down. And like, the rumor was going on that we were looking for another driver. And Chelsea was not even on the list. You know, I told you that. Like, straight, I didn't even think about it. And then, but when you came into the trailer, I'm like, why isn't Chelsea on the list?
That's part of my plan.
Yeah, I was like, what? This is mysterious. So anyway, you know, we talked for a bit, and you know, a few months later, yeah, I'll never forget you rolling up with Cody from BC to our first test at NC Car. And you got in these cars and you're like, whoa, this is how they drive.
This is different.
Yeah, this is different.
I remember like my first lap out, like I'm like overly analytical about everything to a flaw. But like my first lap out, I'm like, okay, there's some crazy shit about this car. This is really cool. This is cool. This is way different. I have to get used to that. Like I'm very open-minded with it because I know it's going to be way different. And I remember thinking like after my first set of tires that like, I used to think Vaughn was like a good driver, and I'm like, he's got an amazing team, amazing car, and all this stuff. And I was like, dude, Vaughn is the best driver in the world. So I was like, he smokes everybody in this thing. I'm like, you didn't know anything different, right?
No.
And I knew what my car drove like, and I'm not saying my car is better or anything, but I was just like, I came from a car that like you could just drive like this the whole time and like be there. And these cars require a little bit more, but it also extracts a lot more from you, and you can find a lot more that way. And I've learned so much driving them over the years that, like, I know there's no other chassis in the world I would have gone this deep in with and found all these little things and wanted to improve and, like, found that, and I've had the opportunity to. But it was just that flip of, like, man, amazing team, amazing driver. It's like, this is crazy. Like, I have some work to do.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah, and I think to clarify for people watching is, like, we went through so many iterations, and when we, back then, we were on an older tire.
Yep.
And the NT05.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
And that tire was not that great. It was an older tire compared to a lot of the new tires in the series.
Yeah. They were just behind a little bit on the making a new tire.
Right.
Which also is great because we got the new tire before everybody else got another new tire.
Right.
So we always like, we're back and forth.
Right. And so we had to put so much in the chassis and the cars were on a knife edge always.
Yep.
Like, you know, I didn't know any different.
Yeah.
So you come along and brought another perspective. And I'm like, what do you mean they're hard to drive? I'm
this
isn't what drifting is? Because I've only been in that car.
I told him, like, you're the greatest driver in the world. Well, because I would go out and I would do something. And then I would look at the data from his car and I'd be like, what? I'm like, how do you even do that? Like, there's so much happening there, right? Yeah. That I didn't even understand, because like my car before was always just locked down the grip, sit it on the rev limiter, like many other turbo cars, and let the car do the work for you. You just suggest where it goes. Where this is like a very intuitive. You tell what to do at every step of the way, which is actually rad in the long run because you can control a lot more. But at that moment, like you were saying, it was like, okay, cool.
Yeah.
You know.
And then I think, you know, for a couple of years, I worked on getting you on board with that.
Yeah.
But you always, I feel, felt there was a point in time where you're like, okay, enough of this.
I was.
You're kind of like, I played your game for two years.
This shit is not working for me.
You did. And you gave it all the effort. And I'm so grateful that you stood up once again, doing what Chelsea needs to do for himself and pushed on it, because now, fast forward to where we're at now, I have the easiest car that I could ever imagine to drive in competition, except for when we missed the setup. But, you know, we're a little too tight or whatever. But, like, it's gotten so much easier by, you know, your brain with our engineer Clay's brain and just evolving it, right? Yeah. And not to mention the, you know, the new Nitto tire that we've been on for a few years has also brought that back a bit. So it's been a very cool compliment, you going from this dude that was never on the list to being a integral part of the team, not just as a driver, but from a, you know, technical standpoint. Like, if you would ask me in 2017 if, you know, Chelsea De Nova was going to have input into the way that we approach competition and our vehicles were competitive, I'd have said there's not a freaking chance, dude. Like, we're OTR. But
that process of me, like, trusting the process and believing it also helped the other bit of it.
Totally.
Because, like, I learned a lot of stuff, things that I liked, things that I didn't like, out of my comfort zone. Why am I out of my comfort zone? Because of this, this, and this. Okay, like, let's make some changes to that. Let's work with what we've got to maximize what we've got. And, like, work within the box that you gave me, you know? And then kind of like, hey, cool. Like, 75% of this is amazing. Let's try to change this first and this first. And then you would come back and drive it and be like, oh, that's different. It's weird. Like, I don't know. And then after a few laps, you're like, oh.
I see. I get it.
The car feels like it's slow, but it's faster because it's easier to drive.
Right.
And sometimes being easier to drive. Yeah, sometimes making a driver more comfortable and easier to drive makes it faster.
Totally.
You know? And that's something that makes no sense. You know, I see people all the time struggling on the track, like, same. And I'm like, free the car up, it'll be faster, you know? Like, what? What do you mean?
Yeah.
And that's it. So it's kind of neat working through that. And even just evolving every year from there, it's been fun and exciting. I was like, I tell people all the time, like, when I had my own program, sure, I had freedom of whatever I wanted, however I wanted, but I didn't have the time, budget, engineers, and all of that, right? So then, like, once we were, like, able to kind of split the difference between, like, setting the cars up, like, a little bit my style, a little bit of the previous style, and whatever, it was, like, awesome to be like, hey, this is the idea I have, this is the theory, and then just, bam, the next time we go
it
test,
happens.
It's done.
Yeah.
And it's done exactly how we planned.
Yeah.
And sometimes it worked. Sometimes it didn't.
Yeah.
But we learn every time.
Yeah, it's funny to process that. It's kind of like a representation of, like, life and the universe in general. It's like those early days of struggle, like, in the end, you're like, I know why I had to go through that.
Yeah, of course. Because
it got me here.
Yeah. Like, and what's really funny is we went back on to a lot of those things that were in the beginning, too.
Yeah.
Like, some of those things that were like, ah, it's too much. It's just too much. It's like, it's too hard to drive. This makes it too difficult. We're making mistakes because of it, you know, blah, blah, blah. Q now, 500 more horsepower later, everybody's super fast and all that. I'm like, hey, remember when we had that and it was too gnarly? I don't think it's too gnarly anymore. Let's go back to that, you know?
Yeah.
Just the evolution of it all together.
No,
I'm going to miss, like, the development of all that. Like,
I know
that's
you
one
are.
Of the most important and coolest things to me is all the development's been awesome. Even James coming in and, like, with the power steering pumps and stuff. And then, like, things that I always was like, oh, I'd like to try that, but there's just other shit that's kind of more important right now. And, like, there's not enough time, this and that. And then James comes in and is like, hey, like, tells me this idea. And I'm like, oh, you're right. Like, I have a similar idea. Not what you're saying, but that's right. That's what we need to do. Like, let's implement that. And almost the first day we drove the cars with him, he's like, dude, this problem that you've been having for the last
Here's
a solution.
I come with gifts.
I'm like, and it was a power steering pump scenario and, like, that whole thing. And I'm like, dude, like, I could kiss your forehead right now if I could reach it. But, like, it's just, like, absolutely amazing. Like, this is a game changer.
Yeah.
And then he's like wanting to do Caster Trail and some other little things, and I'm like, dude, I've been wanting to try this forever, and like you give like gives the confidence. Let's just do it.
Yeah.
Like let's try this.
No, it's been awesome, and I'm like, for me, like I'm grateful that I'm the type of person that's open and not just like stuck. Like I acknowledge that, like, hey, this is all I know.
Yeah.
So if you guys got something else, like, let's try it.
Yeah.
You know, like I'm grateful that I'm open and not just somebody that's like closed off to like this way or the highway, you know?
Yeah.
So that's been fun. And I think, you know, like you say you're going to miss the engineering, but you know, you'll still be involved in it. You'll be watching for it. We talked about that last week.
We just had an engineering meeting like 3 hours ago, and I'm foreseeable future, never driving this car again kind of thing.
Yeah, talking about what's for next year.
And I'm like, well, I think this, and this, and like just give it a feedback. So I'm like, I want them to succeed. I want to see all this. And like,
of course,
even if it's just an idea or a thought or like, or just reiterating what they're saying so that there's someone else that will push that over the edge to make it get done. And you know, it's a lot of effort, a lot of things, especially when you're running three cars and when, like, you know, oh, I want to change this control arm. It's like, okay, well, we need 20 control arms. You're like, what? Yeah, because every car has two. We need spares. We need all that. That change has to be massive global thing, you know?
Yeah.
So it's kind of neat, but.
What are some of your best FD moments with us?
My first time whooping your ass, dude.
Is that Seattle?
Yeah.
Was that our first battle?
That was our first battle with both in RTRs.
Was that 17?
17, yep.
Yeah.
That was a good one.
I'm trying to remember
I was
that.
Like, I'm totaling this car or beating him. Like, this was back when I was like, risk is risk, and that's what's going to happen right now. Because I'm like, he's not going to take the risk, and I am.
Yeah.
Also, I've been watching you all day because I saw him in the bracket.
Yeah.
I'm like, that's once I gotta beat him here.
Yeah.
That's it.
And in Seattle, you knew we were gonna run into each other.
Yep, exactly.
Oh, I do remember that. And I remember watching, and that's when I realized how analytical you were, because you capitalized on just my style and what I was doing, and you put an exclamation point at a couple points that were like,
here's his one weakness, here's his strength. In the lead run, make sure you do his strength better. And in the chase run, take advantage of this weakness.
Yeah. I've never been analytical like that in any competition, ever.
Well, I wanted to beat you, too.
I know you did. I'm good, and I'm glad you did. Because it was.
I also lost the next three battles against you.
Did you?
I had. We were like 2-0. Well, actually 2, I think. I was 2 up on you. It was 2-0. And then you went all the way to 2-2. And now it's 2-3. You actually have beat me more than I beat you now.
Perfect. Now you got a chance to come back sometime and make up for that.
I don't know about that. Maybe I can win some demos. We drive together.
Perfect. No, and then the controversial one, Long Beach.
Oh yeah, that was a good one.
Long Beach, round one.
No, it wasn't. It was at the end of the season.
Yeah, you're right. That was
That's
a doubleheader.
That's why I was so mad about it.
That's right.
Because I was like about to win the championship. It was you and I battling for it.
Yeah, but it was 2020.
It was round 5 because
we finished
and
1-2 that year, right?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't even think about that. I was wondering why Cody was so mad at me.
Yeah. Well, no, yeah. So we go out and, like, I'm running this heat of a lead run. And everything's good. And I was doing this thing to exit outer zone 3. And, like, so I would add a bunch of angle to it, stay in the gas longer than most people, but then do a quick handbrake to reset the car and shoot across. Like, and I had looked in the data a million times, and I'm like, it's faster that way than just using the throttle because it resets the chassis. And here comes Vaughn because I rolled him leaving 1.
He did roll me.
Cuts out or 2 and just like 5 or 6 miles an hour faster than any other run in the chase and just monster jams me.
I still feel like I would have been good, but he's like, no chance. He's like, there's no chance you were making that turn if I wasn't there.
It was so bad that the FD judges were like, we want to see all your data. Kevin wanted to look all this stuff. And you were like 6 miles an hour faster than your lead run in the chase. So. Yeah, you still won, though.
Yeah, I know, but it was like asterisk, and everyone was like, oh, my God. And Miss Chelsea, that night after, we sat down at the table, and she started giving me a whole earful. So you're all welcome for that, because Chelsea could have won the championship, and we would have maybe lost you a couple years.
Maybe I would have been out after that. No, that was a good one, though.
That was.
We were 1-2 anyway, so it was really best case scenario.
That was sick. Was that 18? What year? No, that was 2020. We were 1-2 in 22? Yeah. Okay. Oh, 18.
That's
was
why
Irwindale
it was so
finals.
Controversial, because had I have won that battle, and then I would have, if I would have beat Osbo, that would have been it. That would have been the championship.
Yeah,
and you
was,
didn't even beat Osbo after that.
There
I'm
was
like,
multiple.
Make
multiple,
sure you take Osbo out.
There's multiple other rounds you could have won, too.
Oh, for sure. I'm just busting your butt. Would have, could have, should have, you know? And I wasn't even that mad about it because, you know, it was such a close battle. People were even like, oh, you should have just gave it to, like, you should have just backed off and gave it to me. And I'm like, if I would have won that way, I would have been more pissed.
I know. I had that thought this past weekend. I was like, man, I'm going to win Irwindale. And if Chelsea's got to win to get it, like, what am I going to do?
Oh, you would run me heads up.
I know, but, like, in my mind, I'm like, I can't.
I get
you
it.
Would kill me.
You would have never
if
been
I,
able to tell me
I,
that ever. I would have killed you
I
if
know,
you told me that.
I know.
Well,
I
would have watched it back and been like,
yeah, you
that's
did
it
that.
Right there.
Yeah.
You mother.
Asterisk. Yeah, you SOB. I know.
Yeah.
I would have done it. But it came to my mind, you know, where it's like, oh, my gosh, we're coming into Irwindale. This is what it's got to be.
Yeah. Well, it turned out I really didn't even have to show up.
Yeah, how about that?
Like, I think I needed to
how
qualify.
How cool is
still.
That, though, really?
Yeah,
think
no.
Think about
I,
all the work leading
me.
Up to that.
Yep, yep.
And if our nitrous wants to bite you in the ass at that moment.
Dude, it was funny because he was upset about it, and I know why, right? I get it. Like, but I was past that already, and I was just like, this is how it was meant to be. Like,
oh, it's so you.
Yeah, so, like my
struggle
first.
Struggle for whatever.
My first battle ever in FD. I had failure that was similar, power loss. And my last battle was like that. That's just how it was going to be. I was literally laughing.
I know. When you left me,
I was like,
the whole team's head was just like, oh my gosh.
Fortunately, well, they fought to the last second. Yeah. I was on the radio. I'm like, literally, do not make Kevin pull you off the tire putting air in that.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Those were fighting to the last.
And you left, and I just looked at you. I'm like, I'm trying to like have a half a smile, and Chelsea looks at me, and he's like,
"Let's
I'm
go."
I'm like, you know what it is. Just
yeah.
go send it.
Racing is racing. It'll always be racing.
And it always will be, dude.
I would yeah, so love to finish that
that's
battle.
That's FD.
Off,
what else? What are the other? We've done so many freaking things,
oh, yeah.
dude. Over the
All
past
those
7 years.
Sick toge roads.
Dude, how about our first, so during COVID, when everything was shut down and we went and rented Seneca and we did that night shoot and
that
you almost,
cool. I almost
freaking
died. I almost died.
Oh my gosh.
You want to talk about luck? I've had some shit luck in scenarios in FD, whatever that attributes to, it doesn't matter. I've also had some good luck,
that
and that
was
one
luck.
Of them. I went off at like probably 40 miles an hour at 2:30 in the morning and split trees for like 400 feet through the woods.
Down like, a hill. Like,
and
you,
some
you're off
of the
track
trees.
In a 40-mile-an-hour turn into wet grass.
Downhill.
Right.
And it was probably like a ratio of like 500 feet and like 300 feet of elevation. It was like nuts. And there were trees that were only wide enough for the car to fit long ways. And the car was spinning. And they somehow spun through the trees and didn't hit the trees. The tire marks from that were hilarious.
Yo, it was like you got abducted by an alien because we were running tandem and all of a sudden you're gone and you're nowhere. Like I stopped, I go, Chelsea's going to pull up somewhere. He just spun behind me or something and
no,
gone.
Gone. Gone. Yeah. I hear him screaming on the radio, send everybody to Chelsea, he's off. Like, because
yeah.
he knew how big the hole was.
Yeah.
And I didn't even know, right? That was the problem. I should have scoped it.
What was the name of that? What was that shoot? That was a Type S Tron.
That was
like,
the
we called
one.
It Tron. Yeah, it was Bomb Track. Yeah, Bomb yeah. Track shoot. Yeah, check that out if you guys haven't seen that. That was good.
Yeah.
Let's see. Our latest toge videos.
Yeah, that's going to be sick.
Which we have a new one coming out, which might be out before this drops. If not, I think November 7th is our drop date.
I think this will be out before then.
Yeah.
I don't know. If not, whatever.
Hope so. If not.
If not, I'll put the link at the bottom.
And I almost got hurt on that one.
Dude, we traded spots. That was a close one. Again, a tree pretty much saved the shoot.
I was giving Chelsea
Chelsea
the bro line, and I went ultra bro and got in the dirt, and
ultra
my car
bro.
Just kept going, and there's a 50-foot drop here. My tire drops down, and there's a tree here, and I hit the tree, and it straightened me up. 50-foot
oh,
drop.
Oh, it was gone. Like,
I was giving Chelsea the bro line, and I got my tires
ultra
off.
Ultra bro line.
Super, I was looking out for you, dude, trying to make room. And I went, and there's a cliff right here, and my rear right tire dropped off, and fortunately, this is a tree. I
over
hit
the
tree.
Was over the cliff.
Over the cliff.
Only the left one was on.
For sure. And fortunately, this tree saved my life. I love you, tree. Hit it, straightened me up, and I was good. You can see in the in-car, I was like, I was in it the whole time, like, just committed, I got this, and then just, like, after I was like,
Yeah, I was following you, and so it was, like, a transition and a long extension, and, like, I had my timing where we were going to pull the handbrake to slow the car because it tightened up a bunch, and...
You don't say.
Yeah, yeah, and I'm like, nope, I'm, like, not going to work, so I'm, like, I'm giving him all the room I can, I'm just going to spin out early, right? Which really wasn't that early, because I'm chasing you through the smoke, up through the woods. Like, I can't see very much, but I just knew the timing was off, and I'm like, he's going deep. And I spun the car out to stop, and I see you going for this split between the trees, which is was probably like 40 feet gap between the right tree and the left tree that saved you. Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh, shit, he's going off that through that hole. And, like, you, like, floored it, and I couldn't see because I was backwards. And all I see is you go through the mirror and disappear. And I'm like, did he just disappear because he went down? Or because he went out of the frame of the mirror? So I, like, turned a little bit, and I see you, like, drive back on the road. And I was like,
yeah, you know, like, good save.
On the radio, I was like, good save.
Yes, you like, did.
That was crazy. Just trading spaces on the sketchiest things we've ever done with that.
Was that flashbacks, too? Another one that comes to mind when you're watching me, like, that's not going to work, SEMA?
Oh, yeah.
When I was like...
Oh, the jump? Oh, yeah. Vaughn's like, hey, man, it's the last demo. We're going to hit this jump. They built this, like, big jump.
I'm a big professional jumper, so I'm like, yeah, follow me.
Yeah, he had just, like, you know, done really well. And is like, I think it was first or second year of Ultra 4 stuff.
Yeah.
And I'm like, cool. Like, you know, he's like, oh, just pace me in. Just pace me in. And, like, I've lived my whole life running BMX and trails and pace people in, been the one pacing people in. And, like, we kind of, like, drifting around, we meet up, and we're, like, going. And he's, like, this going, and I'm, like, no way, dude. That is way too fast. And I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just, like, that doesn't feel right.
We're Mustangs, by the way.
Yeah, Mustangs.
Jump out front and see him.
In the drift cars. And I see him go off of it, and I just see the whole bottom of the car. Mind you, it's a tabletop that's only, like, 15 feet, 20 feet. And I just see the whole back of his car, and I'm like, he's going to the flat right now. So I go at my speed, and I jump. And when I land, I just see oil everywhere. Oh. I see pieces of stuff, and I see you, like, limping it back to the spot. And I'm like, maybe I'm not going to follow that pace. It's a good thing I didn't, or there'd be a lot more work to be doing. And I'm sure that didn't feel great.
No. It didn't. It was still spectacular, though.
Yeah, but it was just like that. I was like, nope, And I'm like, we can just shoot this again. Like, I'll just bail. We'll worry about it in a minute.
Yeah.
You know, that's always my process with stuff like that. In FD, I'm like, take the risk. Go. Like,
sure.
You don't have another chance. But on shoots like this, it's like, nah, not feeling that one. We're just going to bail. That was wild. Dude, just like some of the stuff, and like, mind you, like, most of this is after, like, we've been driving for 18 hours. Like, it's a late shoot, it's nighttime, 4 a.m. in the morning. Like, you know, we just keep turning it on over and over and over again. Like, it's wild.
Yeah.
You gotta do it, though.
We do. It's been so fun. Like, I've done stuff with you. You know, like, obviously, I grew up running with Forsberg, and he was, like, the guy that, like, I would always trust to do big stuff with.
Yeah.
But, like, you earned that trust in me really quickly. Like, we've done stuff together that I don't know that I would do with anybody.
Yeah.
Like, right now. You know, like, the night shoots on Toge, you can't see nothing. Disaster is on any other side of it.
Oh, we're gonna put these lights in front of your face.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
light it up.
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks, Nick.
Yeah, thanks, media guys. I'm I'm literally driving into a turn, and I'm about to handbrake with cliffs on both sides. Like... And I'm like, is that the turn?
There's,
like,
a reference.
There's something. I'm like, and then they're like, oh, we're just going to put a bunch of smoke, too. So when you go up to the turn, there's already smoke.
Yeah.
Cool. Anyways, yeah, really good memories. It's been awesome.
It has. It's been.
And I'm sure there'll be a lot more. I'm not, like, ready
to
stop driving.
No, for sure. Yeah,
I mean,
you're not dead, and we're not going to stop driving together and doing fun stuff. I read some of the comments,
yeah,
and it's like,
dead
some
yet.
Of the people are like, to me, I read some, it's like, rest in peace, or, like, you know, shred in peace, or whatever. And I'm just like, yo, the dude's not dead. He's just
definitely
stopping competing.
Not. Definitely not.
You know, like, I don't see, aside from you not being at FD, I don't see much that's going, you know, that's going to be changing. I'm excited to see You know, I'm sure you got some crazy things up your mind. I know you got some crazy build dreams, and I'm excited to see where that stuff goes.
Yeah.
It's gonna be exciting. Like the next chapter of the champ Denofa.
That's right. That's cool. We were talking about that the other day. I was like, that's like one of the coolest achievements ever for me. And it's because, like, I feel like the rest of my life, it'll be like, even my own email will just be Chelsea Denofa, Formula Drift Champion. Yeah. Like, that's the next line right there.
That never will get taken away.
Right. Sweet.
It's a big accomplishment, man.
It is big. It's big for me, too, because I feel like I still did it driving mostly the way I wanted to drive. Like, I just turned the risk down. It wasn't like taking the driving and changing it or adopting a different style or mindset or any of that. It was just like, don't take the risk, like on spots, especially where like somebody could be doing something different than what you expect.
Yeah.
Not on purpose or anything. Just like, I used to take risks in spots where like, even maybe I didn't do the same thing every time. And you're like, that's silly.
Yeah.
But it's just because I'm searching for that like adrenaline and that fun all the time and wanting to do that next thing, you know?
I would agree. Like, I don't think anyone watched your 2023 season. It's like, oh man, Chelsea dialed it back. I think if anything, I watch you just take less risks in the chase.
Yeah.
I mean, that was it. Cause that really what ended up biting you in the ass, just being so aggressive and, you know, lead drivers just not being perfect for you to do that, you know? I'm pumped sitting here right now. Like, dude, couldn't it be a better send off?
Yeah, it was really good
for you. I mean, it's like, you know,
I know. I was like, if I finish the championship second, I might have to come back at some point. Like, and I wasn't like dreading it the way I said it, but I was thinking, I'm like, right now at this moment, I'm like, I'm not going back to FD ever. Like, that's my brain, like my mindset, right? Because I have to dedicate, like, I'm putting, like, my next plan is 3 years. Like, I got to put 3 years to that. So, like, I don't see myself even, like, even if I want to, not going back to FD, because I want to put 3 years into my next plan. And, like, if I would have gotten second, it would have been like, I haven't gotten that and fulfilled that part of it yet. And I think that that would come back. But now that I won, I'm like, nah. Yeah. Maybe I don't ever need to do that.
Yeah, we'll see.
We'll see.
See where it goes a couple of years. I know how I felt after a year sitting back watching.
Yeah, the passion is what it is. It's like my plan moving forward is like, I'm just going to be reckless and crazy and do all the things I want to do. And like,
yeah,
you know, like go out of the box with everything that I can do. Like just drive absolutely bonkers everywhere and push the limits and go faster and do bigger stuff and just like, that's what I want to do, and I want to share that with everybody. You know, like, I want to be able to do what maximum of Denofa is.
Yeah,
you know?
Max Denofa. Never go Max Denofa.
Max D, bro.
It's like full hot rod, dude.
Yeah, I'm
going to
go
that.
Full hot rod everywhere. All next year, everywhere.
Okay, perfect.
I've lined up a slew of cars. No, I'm just kidding. But, yeah, like, that's kind of, like, my plan is to do that, you know.
But you know what?
Take the
risks. Do whatever it is you want to do in any moment.
Yep.
That's the dream.
That's it.